Welcome to the vibrant island of Bohol. After enjoying 5 days of relaxation in Sikihor, we couldn't wait to dive into this bustling tourist hub. Join us as we embark on our DIY island tour, uncovering the charm of Bohol's top attractions, from adorable tazias,
he's looking straight at me,
to an unconventional experience at the renowned Chocolate Hills.
Are they?
Hit subscribe and let's jump into the video.
Okay, so the first stop of the day is the Tazia Sanctuary, but we have to be quiet here as it's a natural habitat for them.
Tazia is a small primate found only in the islands of Southeast Asia. People love to come and look at them as they have really cute faces due to their tiny heads and massive eyes.
So it was 150 per person and we've got a guide taking us around. Looks like a rat.
Yeah.
Also in the jungle, yeah, there's over 100, but we're only gonna see 6 today. But yeah, I love seeing unusual wildlife.
Slippery.
Yeah. Oh yeah, oh. So we have a baby and a mum here in the tree, and they're like tiny little creatures with massive eyes. And rat-like tails, but apparently they don't move much in the day, but at night time they move around a lot and they could jump 3 to 5 meters. Very cool. But they're extremely cute looking. I think it's the eyes. Oh yeah, it's looking straight at me. Right up in the tree.
Oh yeah.
It's like balancing on one leg. Let me see. Alright, I thought that was really cool, but I feel like if you like wildlife, you'll love that. And if you don't...
I like... What are you on about? You always make me out to be some uncultured English guy. We're at this lovely location called the Chocolate Hills. Everyone's like, what are they? I'm like, I don't know, but I rode a bike across the sky. I like wildlife as much as the next person.
But it was, yeah, it was
yeah,
cool.
It was cool. It was cool.
Yeah, they were really cute, weren't they?
Yeah.
Come to the end of the road for us. Next stop is Cowazan Falls. Now, to be one of the top tourist attractions here in Bohol, I'm slightly confused as to if this is the beginning of it. Obviously, it might develop as you go on, but it's just funny, like, is it just flooded or is this where people usually park? But there's water literally trickling from the other field, making a massive puddle, and people have just parked up here. So let's go and see what it's like. And also, question, why is every falls called Cowazan Falls? We don't know.
There's one on every island, so what does Cowazan mean?
What does Cowazan mean? Someone tell us in the comments, or is it just a coincidence they're all called the same thing?
This looks like the where the road is meant to come to, look.
Ah, yeah.
It looks more like a tourist attraction. Looks like there's a, where a restaurant used to be, but it's no longer anymore. You can hear the water.
Yeah.
What do you reckon? Is it going to be a wow or a meh? What do you reckon? Wow or meh?
Wow.
We've been quite spoilt recently though, haven't we?
Yeah.
We're going for a wow.
Now this is pretty cool. Like a mossy kind of waterfall where it's trickling all down in like different areas rather than one steady flow.
Oh, here it is. No. It's a wow. It's a wow.
It's a wow?
Yeah, this way.
Oh my god, it's massive! Yeah, it is a wow. Oh my! The biggest one so far. So always the private huts that you can hire, I guess. They always have them here, clever. And then a massive actual like river, like a thick river that comes out from the waterfall, which is not normal. We've not seen that before. Normally, obviously it just trickles off through some rocks and then, but that's like a full-on river. I actually can't get over it. How can I still be surprised by how unreal waterfalls are? They're all so different as well. Thank you. to go in to get wet because the spray is so intense.
Not the like most like beautiful swimming lagoon, but it's like a wild drop, isn't it?
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
I'll let it flow away.
Ah, is it coming through here?
Yeah. Right, next stop on the list is the world famous Chocolate Hills. However, we saw there's an adventure park nearby, so we've pulled into it and now we don't have a clue what we're doing. So let's go and find out what's here and what's to offer. But so far there's no one around, so we don't really understand.
Very quiet, isn't it? Eerily quiet. There's like nobody here, no tourists. I'm not sure if we're even in the right place, but...
Hello.
Hi.
Where are you from? Manchester.
England.
England?
Yeah.
Land of Afghans.
Yeah.
Thanks.
We have this 1,300. You can do all of this.
Ah, okay.
What is that?
I don't we'll want to do all, will we? But we'll want to do.
So what is it? A rush bike, is it?
Well, this one. All of this. You see the price? $750.
Okay.
So make it 1,300 only.
And what's the most famous thing to do here?
This is both, because here first in Asia. You have also in your country surfing in the air with Chocolate Hills?
No, unlikely.
First in Asia. So surfing in the air, you're going to be your native and surf. And the bicycle zip line, we are the highest one and the longest bicycle zip line only in Philippines.
I guess we'll just do that, won't we?
The bike one sounds the best. I think we just want to do one.
I think we'll just do one drive, because we're going to drive
because
around.
Because if you're going to do the bike zip only, it goes 750 plus 80. So.
But is there anywhere we can get a drink as well? Is
drink? You want to? Just check in the...
In that cooler?
Yes.
Ah, thank you.
Oh, what is it?
It's mango and chocolate.
Oh, you want mango. Fresh mango.
Fresh mango. It's frozen though, so we might have to wait a minute.
That's good.
Yeah? Thank you.
Single bike, only one by one.
Okay.
Oh, no, 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 no. So is this made here and then you put it in a bottle? Mango milk. Oh, no, it's just...
It's caramel's milk something.
So, very unusual.
So 200 steps.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, thank you.
So we're at the world famous Chocolate Hills. I don't even know what they are, but I know that I'm doing a zipline bike. Typical tourist thing. We're at this lovely location called the Chocolate Hills. Everyone's like, what are they? I'm like, I don't know, but I rode a bike across the sky.
No, you'll see them when you get there. They're really cool. But yeah, it's very unusual. What do you think of the milk, the mango milk?
Tastes like
ass. Yeah, I don't like it.
Yeah.
First Taurus. So here we have it, the world famous Chocolate Hills. The attraction is exactly what it sounds like. Rounded hills that go brown in colour during the dry season, so they end up looking like giant chocolate truffles. It is some pretty epic scenery to take in. This is where we're cycling from. And now I'm suddenly scared, because zip lines, you don't have a chance to be scared because you just go fast across. But if we're cycling across, it looks a bit daunting, doesn't it, Gaz?
Nah, it looks fine.
They look really high up and then we're going to cycle across it.
Didn't think about that one before we paid for it.
No, I was just thinking that.
Come and get strapped in.
Okay.
I've been told to get your bag to put in the locker by the man.
Getting strapped in.
That's all you need.
I don't know how it actually works. Do we have to pedal? And
yeah,
then...
they don't just launch you off a cliff with a bike, love.
Oh, mine do. You don't
no,
know.
No, you have to pedal there and pedal back, I think.
I'm a bit nervous.
That's fine. It's not even that high.
Okay. This is very high.
There's two, you're attached on the top and the bottom, look. This is petrifying. It's not actually enjoyable. I am shitting myself, and I can only imagine how Abby feels as well. Abby? Oh my God. This is absolutely terrifying. God. Woo!
Hello.
Hello.
Sit down.
Yeah.
It's really scary. Excuse me, go there.
Over here? Yeah. It is scary, isn't it?
Go back over.
I think so.
Oh my God. You could have heard me, I was safe. Oh my God. Oh my God. The whole way.
Yeah, you should have heard me.
Do I wait here?
No, cycle to the end.
I'm shaking like a leaf.
Just cycle to the end.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh God.
You should go.
Sit down. Woohoo! Here comes the scary part. Oh God, look at that. Look at that. This is actually petrifying now. I'm gonna have to close my eyes and pedal. Jesus Christ, this is scary. Woo. Stop. Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm not putting my arms out.
That was so much more adrenaline fueled than I was expecting. Like, that's two things in the past couple of weeks that I've done that I've kicked, like my fear of
cliff jumping.
Heights. Yeah, canyoneering and that. I'm nearly backed out. It's like a sheer drop.
Yeah, I feel like we didn't think it'd be scary, and then I realised on top. I closed my eyes on the way back and just cycled for ages.
Did you?
Really fast, yeah.
Oh, what, on the way, the last leg?
On the way back, yeah. I just closed my eyes.
I just screamed, that's how I get through.
I literally just closed my eyes and just cycled really fast. Oh. So yeah, enjoyed the views.
Yeah, yeah, I barely looked at them, I was so nervous.
I didn't even, oh, is that where they were?
Chocolate Hills, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't look at them.
I'm sweating.
So in Chocolate Hills, there is one main viewpoint that you can go to if you don't want to do any adventure activities, which is really popular. But we obviously just done that crazy activity, and there was a really good viewing platform there, so we just chilled and had a look out from there. So we don't really feel the need to do that. So on to the next stop.
Risking my life for the speech, guys. I'm in the middle of the road in the man-made forest as our next stop. To us, it's just a bunch of trees. But I mean, what happens is it just get a bit cooler as you go under the shade of the trees when you drive in here, and they're all kind of the same height. It does look quite beautiful, to be fair, all of these big trees towering over the road. What I read online, and if I'm correct with this, is that they were planted for a deforestation project, and they all planted together, and it was like 50 years ago or something, and they've all grown to be at the same height, so it just makes it look really cool.
But it does look quite cool when you drive through.
Yeah, it does look cool, but it's just a bit random because like it's literally a sign saying slow down man-made forest picture taking area. It says that there obviously for the cars who are coming around this corner, and the picture taking area is where the sign is.
Yeah.
So how's that? They just come around that corner, squish.
It's free though, isn't it? Like on the way back from the Chocolate Hills, you kind of just jump out and take a photo.
Yeah, it's good to get a quick stop off. I wouldn't write home about it, but also interesting to look at. Pretty picture opportunity. Should I go and do a jump in the middle of the road?
Go on, do a jump. Do a jump. Now let me do a jump.
Okay. So you're done?
Yeah.
Next up, we come to Bohol Bee Farm for a nice refreshment bake, and we are teetering on the edge of hangry right now. The Bohol Bee Farm has dedicated itself to organic farming, healthy eating, and teaching others the benefits. You can have a tour around the farm, and they also have other activities such as weaving, but we were just there for the ice cream, which was amazing, by the way. As we sat and looked out at the sea, we discussed our thoughts on Bohol. Yes, it is pretty touristy, but for us this was a breath of fresh air. Sometimes it's nice to go to places that have been built to elevate your experience, rather than just seeing it in its natural state. As an island, we found it easy to explore as there's so much information online and a set route that most people follow. This is a great day, and the only advice I would offer is to set off early, plan a lunch break so you aren't hangry at the end like us, and of course wear loads of sun cream when on the bike all day. Thanks for watching. Make sure you give us a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button if you like the video, and we'll see you in the next one.